June 15th, 2017. It's approximately 11:50 a.m. We just had a pretty decent rain out here. The number two garden here has no plastic on it. And I wanted to record what it looked like out here. See all the little patches of grass all through here. It's a constant thing to have to get out when it's dry. We got those four cucumbers growing. And I've got three. I got one right in the middle of that middle bar, about 4 inches out, and one by the outside in the back of those two frames on the backside. Same thing with that one. Sunflowers. Lettuce, which I expect to die off probably in about a week or two, is still coming along out here because it usually thrives in cooler temperatures. But you can see that one there. And where's the other one here? Right there. I think these are buttercrunch lettuce. There are three different types of heirloom, and they weren't growing, and all of a sudden they started coming up, and my wife just said, well, let's see what they do, and they're doing okay. We got four broccoli back there, which also, the end of February is when you want to plant your seeds out here, the ground, especially if you had plastic, which I really wanted to have on this one, but because they need cooler temperatures, I'm afraid the heat's going to kill those maybe in about another month. Zucchini's doing good. We've already gotten four zucchini off that back one. We've had squash bugs on already. We've killed about eight of them. Haven't seen them for a couple days roughly. This one here, we've got a zucchini on there, as you can see down at the bottom. That's just a little smaller than what you see in the stores. So I'm trying not to get, I don't like going out here with, you know, these sandal type shoes. Give me a bruised heel, plus I don't care for wet feet myself. You see, look at all the grass going through all this here. All the skinny tomato steaks is where we're going to put pepper plants. All the 1-inch by 1-inch is from my mama's fence. Those are our tomato steaks, which up until yesterday, I hadn't done what I had done in the back. After my son-in-law, John, made a comment about having holes all through the plastic, and I said I wanted to do something like that. I was using a bow brake, but there's not enough tension on this for me to put a bow brake down. I keep pulling the plastic up. So with a little pocket knife, I got down on my hands and knees, and then after a while I got on that and punctured holes all around the tomato plants so that they can get some water, not just the little holes that they're coming out of. But see, they're curled. I figure today is Thursday. We'll see what this looks like in 24 hours. You can see the curled leaves. I don't know, the corn that surrounds us is Monsanto. They hadn't treated it that I know of. Again, Monsanto can do whatever the hell they want with their toxic shit and not tell us. Most people eat it, so I'm not going to go further on that. But that's about 50 feet off my garden. No, about 40 feet off my garden out back here. And the beans out here, I have a variety of heirloom beans, different types. That one's growing. These three aren't doing so well. Those two aren't doing so well. This is a Good Mother Stallard. No, this is Trail of Tears Cherokee bean right here on this tall one here. I have my fences backwards too. I didn't realize after all these years, the longer posts should go into the ground and have the fencing along the top. Because look how they crawl up the post, and then they would go across on the fencing. But see, the post will have to go down about 6-8 inches at least. And then this is Good Mother Stallard. Good Mother Stallard also here. See, we're letting them up. We want them to dry. They got to watch for pests. These are white beans or navy beans. I don't know what you want to call them. Refer to them right here. And the comments, if people would let me know, you see all that on there? That disease, what are some suggestions for that? This was, like I said, good rain this morning for about an hour. And then, like I said, these four stations here are the white bean or navy bean, northern bean. And then we got two black-eyed peas growing right here. And just so it's not misleading, in each hole, I put two black-eyed peas, two black-eyed peas, two navy, like that all the way down. And that's why they look thick, maybe. Oh, look at the skies out there. I don't know if you can see how the dark blue that is. Cantaloupe right here, watermelon right here, I believe that's a purple hull pea, or a Tiberius, and then that's the other one. One of them is purple hull pea and the other one is Tiberius. I'm pretty sure they're not two of the same thing. My wife planted Swiss chard down there, which not coming up. I don't see anything there with the rain and all that. Here's two Tiberius beans. I like to know why it keeps not focusing. And I got the two okra down there. I meant to have one, but there's two. There's one over there. Now, just to give you a scale. In my foot, and you see that thing? That's the way by the end of June. We'll see what this one looks like. Okay, here's two purple hull peas. Two purple hull peas. Again, everything is about 4 inches, 5 inches above the ground. Two okra. One okra. These are the green okra, by the way. And in the back part, the back half of this garden, see, that's going, now I'm facing, that's facing south, that's south. We've got honeydew, two plants of honeydew. No, I think these are the watermelons, I'm sorry, I keep messing them up. One of them is the sugar baby, which is the round ones, real sweet. And the other one's the oblong, which is like the welt ham, I think they're called. And then over here we have honeydew or a cantaloupe, I'm not sure again. See, and I'm trying to get these to go north. Last year, everything went north, which is why we did it this way. We figured it would go north. You can see down there. I'm going to focus that in a second. Right in the center. Focus. Right there's where the fruit's gonna come out. I keep looking because I feel like I have bugs crawling on my hairy legs. And then these, look at all the flowers on these. When the butterflies, I hope, will be coming here soon, start getting on here. We've got bees like crazy. We had a feeder out just for bees and they emptied that thing in about 20, 30 minutes. So we have a lot of bees out here, honeybees too, by the way, which is something you want, but the same token, when they're taking off about 12 or 18 hummingbird feeders and almost emptying them and keeping the hummingbirds from them, then they become a nuisance. Couldn't tell you if my life depended on it, which bean that is right there. Again, see the fencing is, in, I gotta have them inverted next year. I figured I was gonna use this, what do you call this, chicken wire? I had a 50-foot roll, which I did the same thing. I cut it in half, and I thought, well, I'll make little fences for them, which, again, this is something that I'm learning. With all the mistakes, and I've made a lot in the last 5.5 years, next year, every next year, this is better than it was last year, definitely. The year before was even best, the best one we had. And we got to rotate everything, too. We can't put them in the same spots. But see, I've got two beans down there, two down there. I see one growing here only. Oh, there's not. No. See, I gotta pull out these weeds. There wasn't the one here, but it was dying. It was broke over. Could have been an animal, whatever. So instead of two coming up there, we're only gonna have one coming up out of that hole. Peas, and they look like they have disease also now, I'm telling you. I'm not a horticulturist. See spots on it? Look at this one. Everything out here is as is. I let nature take its course, and you see what the results of that is. Purple hull peas. Purple hull peas. Purple hull peas. So there's six more back here. Well, eight. Again. Two. Four. Six. Eight. And that's the condition of the garden out here. It's muggy out here. It's starting to get humid. It was cooled off after it rained. Like my wife said, though, if it starts heating up, which, you know, you see the sky back there, the manufactured used to be sky. It's going to start baking on us here in about another hour or two. It's going to be very, very muggy. Yeah, that's about 30 feet behind us, right off the side here. That back there is about 120 feet. And then you got about 40 feet from the edge of the garden down to the edge of the road, a road up an embankment, and then another 80-85 acres of Monsanto food-like product. I haven't eaten corn. Last year I had one or two ears from corn that we grew. It was heirloom corn. And all this is, you know, this is a May flower. May, what's it? Yeah, Mayflower pea. Yeah. Anyway, yeah, corn does not really have any type of nutrition in it. As far as I'm concerned, it's just a filler. If you can get actual corn, not the Monsanto crap. This is 160 acres of Monsanto crap. Monsanto wheat was up on that hill over there, which, you know, within a matter of 2 weeks, it was sprayed on and it started growing. So, again, you know, you can be stupid if you want to. I'm trying to do what I think is right for me and my family. Well, these peppers are coming up pretty good. Five peppers in the first row here. And if I'm not mistaken, they should all be jalapeno peppers, but I'm not positive of them. I want some bell peppers, too. Over by the side of the house where we had peppers last year. They didn't come out with anything, but then the year before, we had it really good over there. So we got basil going right down there in that hole. Right down there in that hole. There's two purple ones. One right down there, it does, looks like crap. Again, I can't stress it enough. That's why I have these stones out here, into a sense, to protect them somewhat. The winds out here could actually use the exact title, Winds of Hell, because they've destroyed so much out here because we're out in the open. You know, I actually, if I had the money, I would put a 10-foot L shape out here on the northern and western ends of the garden, just beyond the sunflowers, to help block the wind. And I don't know if that would work. It would look a little better, a little privacy, and I think it would work. But let me go over here slowly and show you the peppers over here. Okay, now that pepper, just as an example, that pepper right there, you can see how small and frail it looks right there. That's the condition, size, whatever you want to say, of all the ones we have out here. When we put them out here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then there's a little scraggly one down there. That's the smallest one. That one, they're usually that size, but we put this one out anyway. And then you get that one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Eight peppers out here. We're going to put a couple, 2 to 3 tomatoes out here, maybe another, or maybe 4 tomatoes out here. And a couple tomatoes over by, I'm sorry, I bothered one of the Hummers out here. Put 2 or 3 tomatoes out there in the number 2 garden that's uncovered. So, whew, man. Yeah, see, I'm standing out here just walking around here. I'm sweating because the humidity out here is so thick. So, in a sense, this is like a really decent, a fairly decent survival garden. Okay, we got some lettuce, we got some broccoli, tomatoes, peppers, beans, lots of different types of varieties of beans, peas, watermelon, cantaloupe, cucumber, and garlic. I didn't show you the garlic. I'm not going to walk all the way over there. There's about 26 garlic bulbs growing down there. About the middle of August, we'll take them up. Oh, man. So, that's what we got.